Picture this. The year is 1968 and two British industrialists, Oswell E. Spencer and Edward Ashford, have founded an international pharmaceutical company known as the Umbrella Corporation. On the surface, their goal is noble enough: to become a major international player in pharmaceutical goods and medical supplies, providing the planet with a steady supply of highly advanced, cutting-edge technology in the field of medicine. As their corporation expands, though, and swiftly, piece by piece, they monopolize healthcare, their true motivations slowly become more and more apparent. In the shadows, their legitimate status as a pharmaceutical corporation is merely a front. Their real sole motivation are bioorganic weapons, genetic engineering, and a whole horror show of some serious Resident Evil. Hello, internet, and welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as we soar across the Arklay Mountains in a flaming chopper, scream into the sky with a submachine gun in hand, and curiously ask the question, what if the tyrant from Resident Evil was real? Roll the clip.
For so long, I thought you were the future. I was wrong. I'm the future.
Well, sadly for us, a real-life depiction of a tyrant definitely wouldn't be musing on their own existential crisis while patiently waiting for a well-timed wall of lasers. Unfortunately for us, we don't all have the impervious plot armor of Mila Jovovich, and a mutated, horrifying, parasitic creature sadly wouldn't be the annoyingly charming one-liner machine of 2007's Resident Evil Extinction. It'd be the unrelenting, stars-hunting, Leon-hating, overcoated monster of the Resident Evil video game franchise, Fedora and all. Ew. But that's a long way ahead. First, we have to outline how the hell we got into this mess in the first place. And believe it or not, it's not too far out of the realm of possibility. Let me explain. Currently, there are a myriad of corporations across the planet that mirror the Umbrella Corporation in their motivation. At the root of it, of course, the Umbrella Corp is essentially just a pharmaceutical company whose first motivation was to do good on planet Earth. Just look through some of their technology, most of which features throughout the video game franchise, and it becomes apparent. AquaCure first aid spray, no more need for bandages. Great stuff. Advil, a more potent painkiller with a quicker release into the body. Awesome. Safsprin, a household name, a common cure for the common cold. This is awesome. Good job, Umbrella Corp, and thanks for saving the planet. But that's how it starts, doesn't it? Good technology that is made with the best intention sells, and it sells very, very well. Just like how the Monsanto company, founded in 1901 by John Francis Queeny, produced caffeine and vanillin during their humble beginnings, and yet would later go on to be tied into the Manhattan Project, developing the first nuclear weapons, as well as being a producer of Agent Orange for the United States Armed Forces during the Vietnam War. Profit margins drive research and development, and with enough time and success, even the best of intentions can become monstrous. And for the Umbrella Corporation, that was the discovery and invention of the T-virus, formerly known as the Tyrant virus, a series of mutant progenitor virus strains that had the ability to infect a wide variety of organisms and reinforce certain characteristics by essentially recombining the host genes. Under special circumstances, it caused spontaneous mutations, and the result, in fiction anyway, was the wide array of horrifying and monstrous creations that form the Resident Evil franchise. Hey guys. So, could a creature like a tyrant ever exist? Specifically a T-103 model, because that's the coolest one, right? Let's find out. As the events of Resident Evil 2 laid out, as well as the surprisingly awesome 2019 remake, the Tyrant T-Type was a series of mass-produced experimental bioorganic weapons created at the Umbrella Corporation. Produced in 1998 from modified clones of the T-002 Tyrant, the T-103 series was the posthumous completion of the Tyrant Project's goal. T-103s possessed intelligence levels close to that of normal humans and could follow orders that were impossible for more primitive bioorganic weapons. Essentially, what they had created was an all-powerful genetic mutant machine that this time, unlike its predecessors, could follow orders. As the events of the Resident Evil franchise highlight, the T-103 model is solely used for military purposes. At their mass-produced level, these bioorganic weapons essentially form the perfect soldier. And if they were real, military powers across the world would be screaming to be the highest bidder to get their hands on these hulking, fleshy machines. And in that, it forms the basis of our answer to this question. If the Tyrant series was real, then military operations across the planet would be severely and forever augmented. But let's take that step one further and actually try and disseminate if this could ever possibly happen. We've got the all-powerful pharmaceutical corporation with malintention, we've got the motivation to mass produce a military commodity, and the final piece of the puzzle is the scientific process behind it. Let me introduce you to Ophiocordyceps australis, a genus of fungi that encompasses around 140 species that grow exclusively on insects. It is highly known for its parasitic behavior on ants, in which when they are affected by its spores, alters their behavior in such a way to propagate itself more effectively. Essentially, it takes control of the ant, forcing it to move to a more contagious area of the colony before killing the ant, quickly growing its fruit on the ant's dead body, and then releasing its spores to further infect the ant colony. There are a few other similar processes in the natural world, but this one is perhaps the most cut and shut. It forces a creature to do something that it doesn't want to do. Sound familiar? Now, I'm not claiming by any means that this could or would ever happen, but after all, we do share a common ancestry with ants, albeit a long time ago. If it affects ants in such a way, then it's not out of the realm of possibility that it could infect humans too. The Resident Evil franchise is essentially the result of the Umbrella Corporation trying and failing to perfect their new genetic strain. The scientific process is exactly that. A process, and as the T-103 model proves, it takes a lot of time and effort to achieve a working model. Take a look at Reanima Advanced Biosciences, a biotechnology company based out of Philadelphia, who are leading the charge in neuroregeneration and neuroreanimation. Very important. They claim to have developed a series of injections that can essentially reboot the brain and bring people back to life. Kind of sounds familiar. Doesn't it? Well, unfortunately, folks, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Before we depart, though, you've always got a lot to say, so let's read out some of your more humorous comments from over the past few days. First up, Demarion the Diamond Wolf says, Jack Finch is his own SCP because he's a floating voice thing. Well, I'm not gonna lie, I'm actually starting to feel a bit like an SCP. Let me out. Next up, Bobbity Bob says, what if... Well, spit it out, Bobbity Bob. We haven't got all day. No? All right, we'll wait. Just kidding, Bob. You take all the time you need, buddy. Well, there we have it. Question is, cheers for sticking around all the way until the end. If you're a fan of this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button as well as that subscribe button, and we'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.